From building electric cars with Tesla to exploring the galaxy with SpaceX, it's safe to say that Elon Musk is involved in quite a few different projects. But not many people know that he's also trying to take over the global internet transmission with his new idea, Starlink. In today's video, we'll be exploring how this project will change the internet and whether it'll be better or worse than our current system. But before we get started, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for more awesome videos like this. Now, let's begin. The internet is a strategic resource now. Anyone who controls the internet effectively controls the world. Especially in today's world, where almost everyone on Earth accesses the internet daily. Just think about how many websites you've visited in the last 24 hours alone. Musk, being the cunning and clever entrepreneur he is, saw this trend and decided to set up his own internet providing service. Obviously, with his futuristic flair thrown in as well. So, what exactly is Starlink? Well, it's basically an artificial satellite constellation being manufactured by SpaceX. Elon Musk announced the Starlink concept back in 2015, and soon after, Musk, Richard Branson, also announced a similar concept of creating an artificial constellation of satellites to beam down the internet. Branson named his venture OneWeb. The first batch of satellites were launched through the Falcon 9 rocket. SpaceX launches batches of roughly 60 satellites every 2 weeks, but in the future, they may use the Starship to orbit up to 400 satellites in a single launch. Currently, SpaceX has launched almost 1,800 satellites, out of which almost 1,200 are functional and being used for public beta testing. The Starlink satellites have to be small to be cost-effective. This is why they've been designed to have a single solar panel instead of two. The satellites have a mass of roughly 260 kilograms, and the krypton-fueled thrusters will be used to position the satellites to prevent space collisions. The satellites will use phased array antennas to communicate with one another and with Earth. What this means is that each satellite will have a bank of receivers and transmitters. The receivers are used to receive a signal from a ground station, and the transmitters are used to transmit the data back to the ground station. The antennas are actually transmit and receive antennas, which means that they're designed to both transmit and receive on the same antenna. This will make it much more efficient in terms of power consumption, and in turn will increase the amount of time the satellites can spend in space. Once complete, the Starlink satellite constellation will form a web of 12,000 small, interconnected satellites around the Earth, operating in low Earth orbit to beam satellite-based internet down to Earth. So now we know what Starlink is, but how is it better than our current internet providers? Satellite-based internet has a few advantages over the normal fiber-optic-based broadband internet that we currently use. Firstly, Starlink will have a low infrastructure cost compared to fiber-optic-based broadband internet. SpaceX doesn't have to lay down costly fiber optics deep through oceans to connect a few select areas. Moreover, fiber-optic cables regularly break down due to damage, causing widespread connectivity issues. The main disadvantage of fiber optic is that the signal deteriorates gradually over distance, especially in copper cables. To compensate for this, a repeater is placed every 30 kilometers. In addition, the signal is susceptible to external electromagnetic influences. This is why all cables are enclosed in rigid tubes. In the case of fiber optics, there's also a problem with the polarization of the signal. If two cables are placed next to each other, the signals change polarity. Due to this, the signal is delayed, becomes unstable, and the quality deteriorates. Since Starlink is based completely on wireless transfer of internet signals, there's no risk of downtime, unless, of course, in the future we have a space war where someone creates a weapon to shoot down satellites from space. Till we reach that point, Starlink constellations should be safe. Apart from the uninterrupted high-speed internet connectivity, There are a lot of other reasons behind the Starlink concept. One most often quoted reason is that satellite-based internet can be easily beamed down to far-flung and underdeveloped areas and regions, giving them access to high-speed internet without any land-based infrastructure. In addition to increasing global connectivity, Starlink also has a technological edge over the existing broadband network. Starlink is expected to have low latency. Latency is the time it takes to send data from one point to the next. When satellites are far from Earth, latency is high, resulting in poor performance for activities like video calls and online gaming. Starlink satellites are over 60 times closer to Earth than traditional satellites, resulting in lower latency and the ability to support services typically not possible with traditional internet. Most internet connections have a latency of 100 milliseconds, which is not good enough for online gaming or other real-time applications. High-speed broadband connections have latency as low as 40 milliseconds, and ultra-high-speed broadband connections can reach up to 20 milliseconds. Unfortunately, it's not possible to get ultra-high-speed internet everywhere on Earth. In most places, you'll end up having a latency of around 100 milliseconds if you're lucky. 4G connections have a high latency of around 20 to 30 milliseconds in areas with good reception. So, with the traditional and 4G connections, you can get high latency, but you'll be limited by areas with good reception. The moment you move into an area with poor reception or an area without infrastructure, you'll lose your connection. Starlink aims to start off with a latency between 25 milliseconds and 40 milliseconds. Elon Musk believes that as more Starlink satellites join the constellation, they'll be able to achieve a latency of under 10 milliseconds, which is a tall claim to make, but if Starlink can achieve this, it'll give them a technological edge over every other internet connection, in particular over China, which is aggressively selling its 5G infrastructure to countries. Thus, high-speed, low-latency internet from the Starlink constellation will trigger a new leap in the development of real-time data analysis, deep machine learning, and artificial intelligence. The main difference between Starlink and 5G is the requirement for ground infrastructure. 5G requires ground-based receivers, similar to cell phone reception towers. China is currently leading the technology for low-cost receivers and is supplying them all over the world. The satellites beam the internet down to these receivers, and then these receivers transmit data to 5G-enabled devices. That means that developed urban areas can easily switch to 5G, but the underdeveloped areas without access to cell phone signals or areas that are far-flung will still need considerable investment before they can have access to 5G. Starlink, on the other hand, doesn't require such infrastructure. The only piece of hardware that the users will need is a satellite dish and a router. These are provided by Starlink with their kit. The satellite dish will directly receive internet beamed down from the Starlink satellites. This gives Starlink an edge over 5G, as well in terms of accessibility and scalability. The access to high-speed internet will also enable a range of new capabilities, including better weather forecasting, autonomous drones, improvements in telemedicine, remote surgeries in hospitals, more functional autonomous cars, better communications. Oh, and we almost forgot the most important reason. Elon Musk has stated that the revenue generated from Starlink will help SpaceX fund the Mars mission. Anyway, it's very important to understand at this point that as internet speed goes up, our data consumption will increase. And as our data consumption increases, there will be more data for companies to handle. This is where artificial intelligence and machine learning comes in. The ultra-high-speed internet, whether through Starlink or 5G, will push the further development of artificial intelligence because it'll be able to carry out real-time data analysis, which is something that humans can't do. As humans, we need time to gather data, look at it, and analyze it. But AI can do all of that in a split second. This explains why Elon Musk is so interested in developing AI through OpenAI, which is another one of his ventures. Last year, OpenAI released GPT-3, which is an auto-regressive language tool that produces human-like text. GPT-3 is already under beta testing and is being used to create all sorts of AI-based text generators that can write not only essays but code as well. It's hard to imagine that this type of technology could be developed by just one company, but that's exactly what's happening. In his own words, Musk said that out of all of his ventures, Starlink is the most ambitious one he's ever tried. Which is true. Has anyone else ever tried to surround Earth in a web of satellites to beam down internet? But surely this means that Starlink internet connection is going to have a high cost. Well, turns out that SpaceX intends to compete directly on price with traditional internet providers. According to presently available data, the one-time upfront cost of the Starlink kit is around $500. And then the internet connection is going to cost $99 for internet speeds up to 50 megabits per second to 100 megabits per second, with latency between 20 milliseconds and 40 milliseconds. This speed and latency is temporary and is surely going to increase as more satellites are launched. Elon Musk has stated that he hopes that by the end of 2021, the top speed of Starlink will be about 300 megabits per second. SpaceX president Gwynne Shotwell recently told a forum on satellite technology that Starlink had no plans to add speed or pricing tiers, with the intention of keeping the service's pricing as straightforward as possible. Additionally, Shotwell said that she expects the $500 upfront cost of the receiver dish to come down in the coming years. SpaceX has already invested almost $10 billion, and it expects to invest $30 billion more into the Starlink constellation. This is an unprecedented level of investment, and the cost of the Starlink connection to the end customer is nothing compared to the investment in internet speeds being provided. But SpaceX also has its eyes on the potential revenue. The global internet market is worth over $1 trillion, and SpaceX intends to capture a large market share of this global internet market in the coming few years. Astronomers and skygazers, however, are not too happy with the whole idea of creating an artificial constellation in the sky. There are concerns that the artificial satellites will hinder ground-based observatories from looking at deep space objects. In response, SpaceX has implemented several upgrades to Starlink satellites aimed at reducing their brightness during operation. Soon, the fast-moving Starlink satellite trains can be visible to everyone on Earth at night. They can already be seen from Earth if you can catch them passing over your location. The satellites are also equipped with krypton-fueled Hall thrusters, which allow them to de-orbit at the end of their life, and are designed to autonomously avoid collisions based on uplinked tracking data. There is another dimension to the Starlink project that we haven't covered yet. We know that SpaceX kick-started the commercial space age. Space tourism is started with billionaires like Jeff Bezos and Richard Branson going to space. China is rapidly advancing in terms of space technology and is trying to make its mark on Mars before the US can send a manned mission. But it's clear that SpaceX has given the US a clear competitive advantage over every other country when it comes to space travel. SpaceX may be based in the private sector, but the US government is directly involved with various SpaceX programs through grants and other funding. We're entering into a very exciting age. Starlink isn't just about increasing internet connectivity, but it's also going to fuel our technological advancement in the decades to come. Our technology is limited by internet speed right now, but with both Starlink and 5G, we will see rapid changes in the fields of artificial intelligence, robotics, and many other industries as well. So, what do you think? If Starlink becomes available in your area, are you willing to switch over to ultra-high-speed connectivity? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section down below. As always, if you enjoyed today's video, and if you want to see more, make sure you hit that subscribe button to stay updated on all our latest releases. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.